Hi there, everyone, and thanks for being with us tonight at 5. I'm Todd Unger.
And I'm Lauren Adams. The fight for Fairfield Lake State Park continues today with another bill filed in the state legislature this week and an ongoing petition. The park supporters are still holding out hope.
Yeah, they sure are. 25 News reporter Andrew Lomparski is here now a week after that park first closed, Andrew.
That's right, Todd, Lauren. The park may be closed, but the movement to bring the park back continues to grow. I caught up with one of the people behind that movement today.
Robert Gillespie isn't giving up the battle over the park he's been going to for years.
I've been hearing from tons of people who have been sharing all the great times they had in the park.
A month ago, he created this Facebook group, Save Fairfield Lake State Park. The day Texas Parks and Wildlife announced the closure, it had just a few dozen members. Now, it's nearing 1,000.
People are saying the same thing. They can't believe how this happened. They can't see how the state let this slip through their fingers.
He's asking people to contact state legislators, two of which have filed bills to allow the state to use eminent domain to take over the park from its new owner. One of those sponsors, State Rep Angela Orr, who also started a petition to save the park.
This is the 100th anniversary of Texas State Parks. This is not the legacy that I think we want for our state park system, to lose a park.
This week, a bill also making its way to the state Senate. Dr. Charles Schwartner of Georgetown filing a similar bill, saying, quote, "The park's impending development will forever compromise our state's precious land, water, and wildlife. Protecting the public's interest in Fairfield is a top priority of mine this legislative session. Whether either will make their way through to law or not, that's another question."
Do you have faith that they will do what they can to get the park back?
I certainly hope they will. Certainly there were some failures in the past, but hopefully now that it's been brought to light, everybody will have a better understanding of that.
From Facebook groups to petitions, pressure is mounting on lawmakers as the gates are shut and the land's new owner remains tight-lipped about its plans.
Today I reached out to Todd Intrist, the land's new owner, for an update on conversations about the future of the park. We're still waiting to hear back. We also learned this afternoon Senator Schwartner is hosting a press conference with Lieutenant Governor Dan Patrick tomorrow. It's still not clear exactly what will be discussed. Andrew Lomparski, 25 News.